In Mari, you can create an ambient occlusion procedural layer which can be useful for texturing. Ambient occlusion, or AO, according to Wikipedia, is a shading and rendering technique used to calculate how exposed each point in a scene is to ambient lighting. Creating it on our model will give us a black and white map of where the geo bunches up, which I often find useful to create masks with. If you were just to throw down an ambient occlusion node, however, nothing would happen, and that's because Mari needs to calculate it first. To do so, just go up to Object, Ambient Occlusion, and Mari will begin the process. When that's done, you can add an ambient occlusion node and it will work properly. If we look at that node now, you can see that I've got darker values in the crevices of my mesh. So I can use this in many ways, but one example I can think of is using it to mask things like dust that I can put in just the nooks and the crannies of the mesh. Now let's talk about Tri-Planar projection. This is a really handy node that steps up the tiled texture a notch and can help a lot when it comes to procedurally texturing. A triplanar projection takes an image that you have and projects it on the three axes of X, Y, and Z across your model. Unlike the tiled texture, it's not UV dependent and works in world space, so it's really useful for more man-made things like brick textures, which I'm going to do here, where everything needs to be equal. If I create a tiled texture in my node editor and put in a brick texture, we can see the issues we have. My UVs aren't aligned all in the same direction, and there's some warping in places. I mean, I could have done a better job UVing, but you're rarely going to get perfect ones. And when it comes to texturing man-made things, this can be a real issue. Bricks shouldn't bend like that. So now I'm going to add in a triplanar projection node. Since it works in three axes, you need to add your tiled texture in three times in the node properties, in the front, top, and side sections. So I'm going to drag and drop it from the image manager. For speedier creation, you can also right-click an image in your image manager and go add to node graph as triplanar. If I view the node, I can see overall it's a bit small, so I'm going to go up to the top and change the world scale settings to something that works a bit better for me. So you might be able to see there are some slightly lighter areas on my mesh, and that's because the node is blending between the three different projections, and some of the corner angles aren't quite picking up enough of any of them. So I'm going to change the fall-off start and fall-off end and make it a bit tighter so that those bits get projection on them. The triplanar is great for any flat surfaces, but as you can see, this curved tube has got some weird results on it. This is one of the downfalls of triplanar projection, so I would probably make a mask for this area and either project this bit by hand on the UVs to clean it up or use a normal tiled texture for those bits. So that's all for this video, but in the next one, we're going to touch on a few ways to keep your layers and node graph working as quickly as possible.